Hi, I'm Pam Witten, and I am thrilled to be at the Ley AI Center. With us today are Selma Shabanovich, founder and director of the R House Lab for Human-Robot Interaction, and David Crandall, the director of the Ley AI Center. So we're going to ask you two AI experts to speak in English for us now, if you will, make things simple. So how would you explain AI in terms that anyone could understand and in terms of, you know, the way that average people will use AI and incorporate it into their lives?
My definition is that computers before were boxes that you type in and they display things on the screen. And I think AI is about the next level of technology. It's about systems that can communicate with us naturally, that can listen to what we say, that can speak back to us, that can have a conversation, that can see the world around them for applications like self-driving cars. And so it's about less about being the static thing that's just programmed and more about something that can learn from the environment, that can get better over time.
I think one of the things that we're also seeing now more of is actually AI that we can interact with. I don't know if you've ever had a Roomba, the little robotic vacuum that people can have in their homes. Voice-activated assistants, all of those are ways that I think we, you know, now even interact with AI as something that is a kind of social agent, not just a thing hidden in the box.
What's interesting is how much we are beginning to see the fact that we don't actually know we're interacting with artificial intelligence. So David, can you share with us what the Ley AI Center is currently working on?
Well, we have something like 60 faculty that are affiliated with the center right now, and they're working on a wide variety of things. Everything from the core machine learning algorithms, trying to make them better, more trustworthy, more efficient, safer, and so on, to applications of AI all around our school, but also all around the university, as well as people looking at the social impacts of AI. Now, it's a very diverse group of people, but I think something that kind of unites us all is that we're actually sort of thinking about people. We're doing it because we think AI technology, if done correctly, could really make people's lives better. So it's about human-centered AI.
That's terrific. The center, of course, enjoys a wonderful international reputation, but I think a lot of that is due in part to the fact that you have compiled a truly interdisciplinary team of researchers, people that come from so many perspectives, that ask questions in so many different ways that I think that reputation is well-deserved. How are the faculty in Ley and beyond taking that research and thinking creatively of ways to translate it outside the laboratory into actual everyday use?
We definitely have other kinds of projects that also reach out into the community. So another one that we work on together with David is with this little robot right behind us, QT, but we call it Iris, the interactive robot for Ikigai support. And what we work here with some of the local dementia care facilities, also with some elder care facilities, and with groups of older adults who come into the lab every month to give us design ideas to develop a robot that can help help older adults sustain, maintain, and then potentially even improve the kinds of things that give them a sense of purpose in life.
We have a really interesting project here. It's called the Trusted AI Project. It is a collaboration with Naval Surface Warfare Center, Crane Division, and Purdue and Notre Dame. Part of it is research, and we are looking at developing new AI technology that's provably secure, that interacts more naturally and more reliably with people, for instance. But it also has a major workforce development component. And so we have about 60 students from IU who are working in this project, being paid by this project. And so the output of the project will not only be the research, but also to be AI knowledgeable scholars.
That's great. I hear a threefold approach. One, designing things in the first place that are appropriate for use. Secondly, helping make sure policymakers are informed so we have appropriate guardrails. And then maybe even most importantly of all, working to make consumers more sophisticated as well.
Exactly.
So that's great. Well, David and Selma, thank you so much for taking some time today and really talking about one of the most exciting things going on certainly across the world. The teams that you have brought together across this campus and outside campus are really to be commended. So thank you for all the super work that you guys are doing in artificial intelligence, because I know we're going to learn so much from you guys in the coming years as well. Thank you.
Thank you.